Good morning. Today is Friday, September 19th, E-Day. I'm Joanna Weinhammer.
And I'm Megan Weinhammer.
And this is Shady Live!
In weather, it's sunny, 56 degrees, with a high of 66 and a low of 59.
Have any announcements that need to be read on Kennedy Live? Send them into the Submit News tab on the Kennedy Catholic website.
Kennedy Catholic High School will be holding a college fair on Tuesday, September 23rd from 8:30 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. in the Commons. There are 30 colleges interested in meeting Kennedy students, so be sure to visit during your lunch period. This is a great opportunity to meet with college representatives and learn more about the academic programs and activities that various colleges have to offer. A listing of college participants and a tip sheet on how to prepare for a college fair is posted in the Navion system, or you can obtain these from the guidance department. It's never too early to check out colleges.
Calling all seniors and juniors looking for community service hours, we need student volunteers to work at the golf outing on Thursday, October 2nd. You must be able to commit to working the entire day from 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. If you are interested in volunteering, please email advancement@kennedycatholic.org or see Mrs. Cantarelli or Mrs. Vettoretti in the advancement's office in the lower library.
It's math madness season. Any student interested in the tournament style competition for the fall, please see Troy Zan, Austin Cohen, or Susanna Cohen.
Attention students, Mr. Courtney will be in the library periods 4, 5, and 6 on a daily basis to assist in any mathematics problems you might be having. In order to take part, you must sign up the morning you want help. Sign up during homeroom in room 128. Get your math year off to a good start.
There you go.
And now for In the News with Emily.
Hey, good morning. I'm Emily and this is the news. France joined the U.S. in the war against Islamic State in Iraq on Friday, conducting its first airstrikes against the Sunni insurgency. French warplanes flying from an airbase in the United Arab Emirates hit at a logistics warehouse of Islamic State, according to French officials. Voters in Scotland rejected independence from Britain in a referendum that had threatened to break up the 307-year union between them, according to projections by the BBC and the Sky News early Friday. Thousands of health workers began knocking on doors across Sierra Leone on Friday in search of hidden Ebola cases, with the entire West African nation locked down in their homes for 3 days in an unprecedented effort to combat the deadly disease. Well, that's all for In the News. Back to the anchors.
Thanks, Emily. And now over to sports with John.
Good morning, Kennedy Catholic Sports Nation. I'm John with your sports. Today, there's boys varsity soccer at home versus Mount St. Michael's at 4 p.m. and a varsity field hockey home versus Chapin at 4:30 p.m. Saturday, guys, it's homecoming. Come on, let's go. It's homecoming. You gotta be there. 1:30. Let's go. All right, guys, that's all for sports. Come to homecoming. Back to the anchors.
Thank you. And now for this day in history with Michaela.
Hey guys, this is This Day in History. In 1881, the 20th President of the United States, James A. Garfield, died of wounds inflicted by an assassin. In 1970, the first Glastonbury Festival, which is one of the biggest music festivals in the whole world, is held at Michael Eavis' farm in Glastonbury, United Kingdom. And in 2011, Mariano Rivera of the New York Yankees surpasses Trevor Hoffman to become Major League Baseball's all-time saves leader with 602 saves. That's all for In the News. Let's go, seniors!
Well, I'm Joanna Weinhammer.
And I'm Megan Weinhammer.
Get what?
And this has been Kennedy Live.
Have a great day!